I came to Caltech for multiple reasons. The most pertinent of them is just the collaborative nature and the strong sense of identity, and most important to me is the research-based education.
I'd felt a yearning, one might say, always to come back to Caltech after graduating. There was something very special about Caltech, which was a really true and passionate love of science that I felt here. This is really not just uncommon, but non-existent anywhere else.
What you can see about Caltech is that people take on problems that might seem impossible. I was so naive, I didn't really know how difficult it was to engineer proteins reliably. But because I was in a place where people routinely did that, I wasn't afraid of doing it.
So I'm particularly interested in self-propelled nanoparticles. So I use computer simulation to really understand how these things work. There's some potential that you're the first person to really look at this behavior, and being like the person who's actually pushing the boundary forward is kind of why I get up in the morning.
The Division of Geological and Planetary Sciences wanted to bring someone to Caltech who had an interest in studying questions related to the history of life on the planet, but for that person to be able to bring tools of molecular biology to bear on those questions. And that was something that I was beginning to develop, and they took a chance on me and hired me.
Caltech is a very adventurous place. We love risk-taking. People are not afraid to fail. And in my case, I'm interested in combining neuroscience and economics, which are two fields that are traditionally very far apart, but there's a lot of interesting stuff to do there.
Caltech realizes that some of the most important questions facing our society today are ones that are not going to be solved overnight. They're questions that demand innovation at every level. It takes time to do that.
Time to sit and concentrate, which is one of the most valuable resources a scientist, at least a theorist, could ask for.
What LIGO has done is to open up for the first time an ability to see this aspect of the universe that lives side by side with stars and planets, and yet has never been seen before. It gives humans for the first time the possibility to learn about the warp side of the universe.
So my research is in computational biology. It's not just that we do experiments and then go and analyze the data. The computer science is developing the technology and the experiments, and they can be used to better understand the molecular biology of the cell, and also developing diagnostics for health applications.
I combine quantum information theory with thermodynamics. This combination informs our basic fundamental understanding of the flow of time, how efficiently we can process information, and other fundamental ideas.
You can make an incredibly long list of the awards that have been won by Caltech faculty and alumni. It reads as a who's who of science. But what does that mean? That means that their work has had a huge impact on the way science is done, on technology, and on the way we live today.
Caltech is changing the world in a number of different ways. One is just the cutting edge research, which leads to new technologies. But I think also the students that come out of Caltech too. These students go other places and take what they've learned here, and they're able to share that knowledge.
Caltech does train the next scientists. I think it's really cool to be part of that group.
I feel like every time I turn around, I see someone who has invented a new field. It makes me want to strive to make the quality of my work not just very good, but extraordinary.
Breakthrough, the theme of our campaign, reflects the courage of those who are in our environment to be able to push themselves to break through to the next level.